morning to everyone. I'll introduce myself first. Maybe I am a new face to you because since 1 month you are new sir, mechanics sir, mathe mathematics physics class anna kelta bandidira. And I'm going to take the chemistry portions. Myself Mamta. Today I'll take the one of the important first chapter of chemistry. No need to worry. The regular classes also I am going to repeat the same topic, but for a time being today I'll just give an introduction to structure of atom. Okay, is this visible and audible from my side? Okay, I can't see you all, but you can see me, right? And yesterday I know, so yesterday you have taken mock test for chemistry, right? Somebody was shocked, maybe with confusion, that I have given the question paper in from my bag. Okay, thank you, sir. Okay, if you have any doubts regarding my class, you can ask me in chat section also. And see, it is new technology for me also, but you are familiar with this live class. What I am saying is, if you have any doubts, you can clarify with me in later by asking me any questions regarding my topic. Okay, actually we have to do some basics concept in this class, rich classes, but I thought I would take it is also basic, no? The structure of atom means you will be familiar with. All of you have studied so many things in my chemistry classes, as I already taught by M.K. Naik sir. He has taken one of the chapter regarding the organic chemistry. He has discussed carbon, carbon valency, and what we can say, like writing formula for carbon, organic compounds for alkenes, alkynes and alkanes, and some other organic compounds, right? See, carbon, it's an atom, or we can say element, one of the element found in periodic table. You know, no, periodic table. Okay, what is the difference between element? It's visible, my handwritings are visible for you. Yes? Okay. Now this element and atom. Okay, atom. Okay, it's the smallest particle. Okay, it's the smallest particle of matter. Okay, matter, right? Element. It's a combination of atoms. You can say it consists atom. Okay, right? So we'll take first atom. So today is my topic is, that is structure of atom. Okay, I told you atom is the smallest particle of matter, any matter. See, this is also one matter or object, we can say. In chemistry we will take it as a matter, or blackboard or bench or anything, any object is visible to you, it's a matter, right? This chalk piece, we'll take this example. This chalk piece is made up of many atoms, means we can cut it, we can see this particles, right? Individual atoms we can see, right? Okay, this, if it is saying this is, who is there? This is matter. Okay, for this particles, who has given the name for this? It is atom. The particles this particles for the matter, which is composed of atom, this name someone has to name, no, this particles for particle na name particle va atom na they have name. Who has named this as a atom? It has been named by one of the British teacher is John Dalton. Okay, he introduced the word atom as an atom is the smallest. He told atom as the smallest particle, smallest, okay, indivisible particle. He told it is the smallest individual particles. Means according to him, atom is the ultimate, okay, ultimate particle of matter. Okay, matter na ultimate particle is atom. Atom in the compose agide matter, every matter anta he explained. But the thing, this theory, this word of it is there, no, indivisible. It was proved wrong later by some other scientists who made the discovery of proton, electron and neutron. That we'll discuss later. But initially he given the statement made up of matter is made up of atom and atoms are the ultimate particle, that is it cannot be further, this cannot be further divided. It's decomposed manakala, right? It cannot be further divided by any other means, yavde chemical means or physical means, by any other chemical means or physical means, na we can't further divide the atoms. It is the ultimate, last point. He explained like that. But this is the statement he has given by the atom. He is given for the atom. That is, he introduced the name, that is atom. Atom is the smallest individual particle. Indivisible particle. It is like that. Okay, clear? And he also, this atom, he has taken this word from Greek language. Okay, it is there in your textbook, you can see. Okay, I think it is general, maybe you have studied in your previous classes, because it is not a new thing, that is atom, elements or those things. Okay, this is derived from the Greek word which means atomio. Okay, this is derived from the Greek word, that is atomio, which means, this means atomio means uncuttable, means we can't further cut it or divide it or decompose it. Okay, or we can say non-divisible or non-decomposable. Okay, this is the statement given by the Dalton for an atom. Okay, and he has also given some other postulates regarding atom. He told first it is the smallest individual particle of any matter, and also he told each element. Okay, each element consists of, each element consists of unique kind of atom. Means here, see, if we can say carbon element or nitrogen element, oxygen element or fluorine, halogen, whatever the elements you can take, these elements consist of unique kind of atoms. Means carbon element over there, it has only carbon atoms. Okay, and nitrogen means it has only the nitrogen atoms, no other elements, no other atoms. Oxygen means only oxygen atoms. He told each element consists of unique kind of atoms. Okay, unique kind of atoms, and these atoms have its own identical mass. Adante ada mass irutte. Okay, each element consists of unique kind of atom, and each atom has its own identical mass. Okay, carbon ke carbon de ada mass ide, oxygen ke oxygen de ada mass ide, hydrogen ke hydrogen de ada mass ide. Okay, then later he give another statement that atoms of different element. Atoms of different elements have different properties. atoms of different element have different properties. It is not there in your this one, but for your knowledge purpose, I am giving these statements. No need to bother for this one. And this is a basic concept I am teaching. So this will be repeated in your regular classes. Okay, they told that atoms of different elements, okay, have different properties. It's clear, no? It's nothing. See, each elements have identity. Each elements consist of unique kind of atoms, and it has its own mass. Means, if carbon element has carbon element, you are taking means it has only carbon atoms, and nitrogen you are taking means it is having nitrogen atoms, right? And next, and it is having its own mass. Carbon ke carbon ke mass ide, nitrogen ke nitrogen ke mass ide, oxygen ke oxygen ke mass ide. The next question which is given, atoms of different element. Different elements. If you are taking nitrogen, or else you can take any other, Fe, iron, or else you can take argon, neon, or else you take hydrogen, okay, carbon, okay. These have different properties. This is the different atoms, no? Different atoms of elements, of different elements. So it has their own properties. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇದರದೇ ಆದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ವ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಏನೇ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ರೇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಐರನ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದರದೇ ಆದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇದೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ನನಗೆ ನನ್ನದೇ ಆದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಇದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮದೇ ಆದ ನೇಚರ್ ಇದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ನನ್ನದೇ ಆದ ನೇಚರ್ ಇದೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೋ ರೈಟ್ ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ನೇಚರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಕಂಬೈನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಓಕೆ ನೀವು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ವಾ ಟೇಕನ್ ನೀವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಆರ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ರೆಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್ They also has given questions has been given different radicals and you have written the answer different acids base you have written right similarly this is same this also same atoms okay different atoms okay combines in a ratio difference it may be similar or different atoms combine in a fixed ratio adarde ada ondu same ratio it may be 1:1, 1:2 it should be whole number okay it will combine in a fixed ratio to give molecule for example I'll tell you Na plus okay plus Cl minus or you can take any other example okay it will give a NaCl this is nothing but molecule or you can say compound okay it will form a molecule for this we have ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಕಾಮನ್ಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇದೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಬೈ ದ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಬೈ ದ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾರಿ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಓಕೆ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಓಕೆ bonds we can say chemical bond so this is formed by the ionic electrons will be completely transferred from one atom to another and one bond is formed and the molecule is formed means different atoms okay different atoms of or atoms of different elements combine in a fixed ratio to form a molecule this is also one thing okay and another He has given the postulates that is, he is given last postulate, maybe fifth postulate. See, he told that the chemical reaction which is occurring, okay, the chemical reaction which we are going to deal or which may be coming across in our whole chemistry syllabus, it is just a reorganization. In the chemical reaction which occurs, it is just a reorganization of atoms. Okay, just atoms in another reorganize are there. They reorganize and it will give the final product. We'll say I can take it is X plus Y. Both are reactants, right? It is the atoms. We can say reactants or atoms. We can say it will react as I have explained earlier. In the NCl, it will be NaCl molecule. It will give the product that is XY. Means here just the atoms rearrange. Okay, rearrange. Okay, reorganization takes place. Okay. This sort is. If you have any doubt, you can ask me later. Okay, I know I'm not getting in this chats. Okay, so this one X plus Y. This is the reactant. You can consider it as an atom. This is known as an atom. It reorganizes to give the product, the molecule or the compound. You can say here we can say both the reactants, no? X plus Y. For example, I'll take H2 plus O2 or yes, O2 will say it will form water molecule, right? Correct, no? You can balance here 2 2. Here in this product we can say both oxygen and hydrogen, no? And the reactant also, yes, Suraj Mahal, it's a bridge classes only. But I thought I'll take some this one, some basics. Okay, not I'm not going in depth. Don't worry, I'll take in the regular classes as I have already mentioned you. I got some brief introduction. I'll give you that chapter. In the later class, I'm going to take any some other topics. Okay, just I have given the structure of atoms to give you the introduction for atoms. That's all. Okay, it is not a regular classes chapters. Just is the introduction. Okay, is that clear? I don't know what you have the doubts. Everyone is asking whether it is a chapter or this is a just bridge course. I don't know. I told you, no, this is just a bridge course classes I'm having. Okay. Now just I give the introduction, no need to worry or no need to bother for these things. I will repeat once again in the chapter in detail. I am going to tell you. Okay, is that clear? If you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay, just I am giving the postulates and just I am giving the hints. Okay, no other extra things I am doing here. Okay, if you have that many doubts, means I will stop here only. If you are getting confusions that I am dealing with the chapter. Actually, this concept is there in your textbook, but it is not a new thing that you have already studied in your previous classes. Now, atom and then the culture, element and then the culture, right? And then just to refresh my previous thing, I am refreshing this one. Is that clear? Is this clear? Okay. Okay. And see. I think I should have taken some other classes, no, so that you will not get confusion for this one, that I have started the syllabus and all those things. Okay? Okay, no problem you have? If I continue means? Okay? Okay. See, this is just for introduction class I have taken. If you for next other classes, I will take some general topic itself, okay? I thought the first class, no, I will take that only from the chapter only, and this is not a new thing to you guys because you have already studied in the previous class. Atoms and the kalchidra, elements and the kalchidra, compounds and the kalchidra, right? Right, no? So I just started from the atoms. So I have written the this is a heading, the structure of our book. That could confuse for you, right? That make you confused that whether it's a chapter or a whether it's a chapter or just a bridge graph. Okay, I'll just rub the structure of it. I'll just read with this one. Okay, no? Okay, thank you. He has given these many things. No, I told you in the initial that he told, that Dalton told it is the smallest individual particle. Okay, it is the smallest individual particle. That statement he has given, that is, it is the ultimate particle of the era of Galileo, it was proved wrong. Okay. After the discovery of proton, neutron and electron by some other scientists. Okay. This atom, which is the ultimate particle of matter, this concept, and he told that it cannot be further divided. And no, a concept is there. This was proved wrong after the discovery of proton, neutron and electron. Okay. Okay, na? Okay. And what I can do, whether I will stop or I will continue, because you will get confusion if I continue means. Yes, I know this is your first pew and you are from the first pew, you know. Yes, this is first PUC or Sempo Suresh, first PUC, no? You are from first PUC, right? I am not taking any second PUC classes or any other other chapter apart from your syllabus, right? This many confusions you have, why? Why you have this many confusions? I told you that I will take this chapter, entire chapter in the next coming classes when we are going to meet face to face, right? Alva? Face to face, yavaga will take regular class. That time reply to me that whether I have to continue or whether I have to stop here only, because you are getting so many confusions. Or else I will take some other topic regarding, or I can start some other topics. I will stop here only. I don't know why you are getting confusions. Because see, this is your chemistry class only. This is your first chapter only. But see, all other things we have to first basically we have to learn with them, no? Yes, you are applying, but some other saying, ma'am, is this for first PU or I know this is first PU class only. For that reason only I have texted you, no? I have messaged you that I am going to take first PU class. Okay, continue. You are saying continue, I'll continue. Or else otherwise stop, I'll say some other general informations. If I continue means I'll continue. Okay. See? This one, this concept of Dalton has been proved wrong after the discovery of, just I will take one concept, that is discovery of electron only I will take, how it has been discovered, that one I will take and then I will stop. Next time onwards I will take some general topics so that you will not get any confusions regarding the bridge core classes and your theory classes. Okay, is that clear? Okay. This time it is almost a story, no? It is just like a story how he has discovered. It is also there in the textbook and no need to bother whether madam is taking theory chapter class itself or bridge classes itself. I just given one just a brief brief story regarding how he has discovered how the electron has been discovered by J.J. Thomson. Okay, so that one concept I'll discuss later. You can we'll discuss some other general topics, okay, interesting topic of some other like inorganic or organic from physical, but some topics I will cover. Is that clear now? Is it okay? Okay. I told you. Again, I'm repeating. Delta, we told that this atom is the ultimate and it is the final particle. It cannot be further divided. It is the ultimate particle and it is the individual particle. He is given the statement. No, it was the first postulate introduced by the Dalton regarding the atom. Right? Later, it was proved wrong by the scientist, that is J.J. Thomson. Thomson, after the discovery of electron, okay, and his student, he discovered next proton, and his student, he just next further discovered neutron. Okay, after the discovery of proton, the student of J.J. Thomson only discovered the discovered proton, and next his student later discovered the neutron. Okay, atom, it is atom. If you are taking atom, any atom, and one more thing that the Dalton has told, that the atom has a spherical structure. Okay, spherical structure is just like a ball. Why it is ball only? Why it is having spherical structure only? Because here anything we can see in our nature, almost it is of spherical shape. It, the, why only spherical shape we consider? Why can't it be rectangle or square or else? So most of the things which we are going to see in the nature is of spherical shape only. So the reason is, in spherical structure, the friction. The friction is less, and the structure, if you are considering, the spherical structure is having more stability. Okay, so he told that atom is having, that is, spherical structure. If you are considering the spherical structure, the nucleus, the atom is having proton and neutron. This one we know, right? This is the before the discovery. Okay, I'm telling. Means after the discovery, I'm telling this one is atom is having nucleus, inside it is having proton and neutron, and the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, right? Electrons are revolving around the nucleus, right? This we know now, but during the period of Dalton, this concept was not introduced. He told the atom is the ultimate part and it is not having any other particle. But after the discovery of electron by J.J. Thomson, it was that the Dalton theory was proved wrong. Okay, how he discovered this electron? This is the history now. Okay, this is the history now we are having. Discovery of property of electron. Okay, discovery of electron by J.J. Thomson, or you can say it is CRT. Okay, cathode ray tube experiment. Okay, what is going to be the initiation for this discovery of electron? Okay, we can see, no, during rainy season we will see the lightning. See, if somebody has the capability or potential to show someone is wrong, means he has to have some observation from the nature, right? Just like we can say gravitational force is discovered by Newton, right? So I said Newton. How is this? Because by accident only all the science, all the discovery is just is the result of some accidents, right? Okay, Newton discovered the gravitational force by when he was under the tree, he some fruit like his fall on his head, and he thought why it came only down, why it can't go up. Okay, this is the reason he introduced that it has we have there, that is gravitational force is acting on a, any object, right? Okay? Okay. Yeah, I can continue. So, all are replying, that is I can continue. Okay, I will continue. Gravitational force is acting. Okay. So, now we got the term G and G has given some values for G, values of G. This is the discovery. Okay. So accidentally he discovered the gravitational force acting on an object. Similarly, for Sir J.J. Thomson also, this discovery of electron is just came by some other natural phenomena. He was encouraged by encouraged by one of the natural phenomena. That is, during rainy season we can see lightning, right? Like you mean this one, lightning will be there, right? So the reason for that lightning initiated this scientist J.J. Thomson, why this lightning will happen? Okay, why only it is happening in nature? Why we can't conduct? Whether we can discover, like why whether we can produce this light or light rays in our lab? This only tempted him to discover this electron. Okay, he made an attempt. Okay, he was before this one. Faraday has introduced the DC battery, you know, by touching two electrodes, it can produce the spark of light. He introduced that one. That he introduced the DC battery, right? That the using that theory itself, he started working on the this one. The reason for the rays, that is light rays. Okay, so he conducted an experiment by taking he just collected all the information regarding this one. See, the lightning will come in appears in the vacuum region only. Okay, vacuum region. So for this experiment, he need vacuum, right? Vacuum. And that is inert atmosphere, right? Inert atmosphere means we should have inert gases like helium, neon, argon, like inert gases, right? Right now? Okay. So we have to create inert, that is vacuum, and upper side, this still atmospheric sphere, we have pressure, which we can experience, right? But when we go up, the pressure will decrease, right? Pressure will decrease. No much pressure is there in the vacuum region, right? So, then first thing we have to create the vacuum. Second thing, we have to maintain the low pressure. And the third thing, we have to produce light, okay? By connecting the battery, okay? By connecting the battery or power supply. Okay, and another thing, the thing which we are going to happen by doing the experiment, which has to be visible, so we have to take a transparent material. Okay, so whatever the observation is going to happen inside the chamber, it has to be visible, no? So, he thought he has taken one glass tube, okay, transparent glass tube, okay. Just taken one glass tube, transparent material. Then, roughly I am drawing this one, okay, later we can see clearly. Here he has maintained the vacuum, okay? He has maintained the vacuum. Okay, no? Vacuum for the introduction of inert gases. Okay, here there is full vacuum. He is filled with the inert gas. Okay? Then next, these two metal or electrode he has taken. You know how electrode, you are going to study in electrochemistry. Right? This one he is connected to one DC source. positive. Two terminal will be there, positive and negative. Okay. This one we will call it as cathode. This all the terminologies I am going to explain to you in the next physical chemistry part. This one is anode. Okay, anode, cathode, two electrodes, right? So he made a two power supply. He made an setup like he has taken two electrodes and he is connected to battery, right? And he has taken a glass tube so that we can see the observation which is going to take part inside the system. Okay, he has taken the glass tube and this he has introduced the inert gas so that he can maintain the vacuum inside the tube, and he also here pressure he has maintained around 10 to the power 2 to 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, low pressure he has maintained. We can generally say it is here maintained low pressure inside the tube. Okay, is that clear? Now the setup is ready. Okay, the setup is ready. Then he applied around 10,000 volt. Okay. He applied around 10,000 voltage across the battery and he saw that some rays are generating inside the tube. Okay, some rays are generating inside the tube. Just I'll write like this. Okay, some rays are generating inside the tube. That is light rays. Light rays it is generating inside the tube. Then we got that this lighting we can also produce by experimentally in our lab also. Okay, so he got success in his experiment. That is, we can produce light rays manually in our lab by experiments by this using this setup. Later, shall I continue? Okay. This one small topic I'll finish, then I'll stop. Okay. Then he applied 10,000 volt source and he observed that some light rays are producing inside the between the electrodes inside the glass tube. This when some results he obtained his next, we will try to for next steps. We will get curiosity that why it is producing the rays, what may be the properties of this rays, what may be this rays. Just in you will come to know that something is producing inside the tube. Okay, what it is? The next question will come in our mind, what it is, what may be the nature, why it is producing. Okay, these all things will this normally these things will come in our mind. Same thing he also thought like what will be the what is the reason of this how it is produced, what may be the nature, what may be the properties, what is the reason for this. All those questions will also arise in his mind. So next what he thought, till here he was not knowing this is a electron. Okay. This the rays it is coming from this electrode. It is electrode. Later only after his series of experiments only he came to know that these rays are termed as electrodes, and some other statements also he is given. Okay. This is just he come to know that we can produce the light rays. Okay. That is rays he can produce experimentally by manual. Okay. The next setup what he has done. He want to know from which electrode the rays are producing, whether it is from cathode or it is from anode. We also having doubt, no? So from which electrode the rays are producing? So he want to know, no? So for that reason, what he did? He just modified this experiment. He just modified his setup. Okay. What he did means, see, another thing while Galileo did the next set of experiment, he did some modification. Okay, he just initially he has taken 10,000 volt. No, this is of too high voltage, right? 10,000 volt means it's of too high voltage. So he want to reduce this voltage, right? He he want to reduce his voltage. So what he did is, he just to reduce this voltage to around 2000 or 3000 volt, he just decreased the distance between the electrode. He just minimized the distance between the electrode, that is B. And also he has taken inert gas to create the vacuum. He has taken the inert gas relay, because helium, it will produce a vacuum at low pressure and it requires very less voltage. Okay, so this is the setup here, that is, he has minimized the distance between the electrode and he just introduced the helium gas so that it can take the low pressure. Okay, the next is, you want to know from which electrode the rays are coming. For that reason, what he has done is, he just connected another battery. Okay, he just connected another battery. Okay. What did he do? He just connected another battery. Then he supplied voltage. Then he saw that. Okay, he saw that the rays are coming. Okay, the rays are coming. Before that one, he has to know from which electrode it is coming. No, from which electrode it is coming. So, yaav electrode inda bandide anta he has to confirm the first. For that reason, what he has done, he immersed some material, like something which he has having. See, something may be metal, some pieces have some other thing he has placed here. Okay, one object he placed here inside, in between these two electrodes. Then he saw that the image of this, the shadow of this was, and he has placed some fluorescent material here, that is Xenonex, okay, screen he has placed, so that the shadow has to be fall on this screen, no? So he has placed this screen. So when he has applied the battery and when he has placed the object, the shadow of the object is falling on the screen. Okay, the shadow of the object is falling on this screen. Then what happened is, see, he concluded that, see, whenever we are standing here, when I am standing here, means the light is coming, sunlight is coming from this direction here. My shadow will appear in the next, behind me, no? Right, behind me. So, he saw that the shadow of this object is falling on this screen, okay, in this screen. Means the rays are coming from this direction, no? Falling on this direction, and the shadow is appearing this, you know, behind the screen. So, the rays are coming in this direction from this electrodes. Thus, so we conclude that the rays are coming from cathode, electrode. That is negative terminal, that is cathode. Since this is for the reason, so he is termed this one as cathode rays. The rays, it is coming from cathode, so it is termed as cathode ray. Okay, cathode ray tube experiment. So the rays are coming from the cathode. So the cathode ray tube experiment. Okay, this is clear. Now everything is clear, that is, the rays are coming generated from this electrode. Okay, then next, charged only, but we have to give the proof. No, we are saying by your own means that it's not valid. We have to give the proof, right? That it is having negatively charged, it is negatively charged particle only. Sorry, it is negatively charged rays only. We have to prove, right? For that reason, what he has made means he just introduced another battery. Okay, he just introduced another battery. Okay, like this. He just modified his experiment. Okay, or he just introduced another X1 battery. When he is applied this battery and when he is given the power supply, like source, power source, voltage, the rays which is generating from, which is coming from cathode, is just it is deflected towards this. This is positive, okay? This is negative. Just deflected towards the anode of this second battery, means positive terminal. See, we know that like forces, like charges will always repel, no? Like charges, positive, the negative, whether it will come close, no, right? Right, it will not come close, it will repel each other, right? Similarly, here it is negatively charged. Since it is negatively charged, we don't know whether it is negatively charged. We know, but he was not knowing, no. It is common that is, if it is coming from the cathode, means it is known thing that is, it is negatively charged. But he has to give the, he was having maybe it is negatively charged, but we have to give the proof. No, he has to give the proof. Otherwise, we are not going to accept whether it is negatively or positively charged. So, now accept mark on Allah without having any proof. So, he did this experiment. He found that the rays coming from this cathode is just deflected. The turn I do. It is turned towards the positive, that is anode of the X1 battery which we have applied. From this he concluded that the rays is negatively charged, means it is attracting towards positive charge, positively charged electrode. So it came to know that these rays are negative. It is positive terminal. It is obviously it is negatively charged, right? If it is positively charged, it is positively charged argument in case. Okay, it is not because it is coming from the cathode. So now you know, but initially we were not knowing. So it is negatively charged cathode in the bundle. If it is positive terminal argument, it is expected. But is it reflected towards this anode? Means unlike forces which always attract each other, no? Positive, negative, it's nothing, no? Magnetic, it could not be like that. You would have seen that. There are simple observations. If you get a magnet, it could not deflect after reflect. Ripple after the end, maybe those terminals are same terminals, are the same poles are going to be, correct? And I attract after the end, are different poles are going to be, okay, I think you will be having next classes, so next class, I may continue this one or else I will be starting with some other new basic concept, okay, so that you should not get any confusion whether it is chapter or whether it is bridge car classes, okay? If you want to me to continue this class, means you have to text me, right? No, sir. You have to answer me whether I have to continue this itself or else I have to take some other basic concept. Means you just inform me so that according to you only I will continue. Is that clear? Thank you.